Morning.
Happy Thanksgiving.
Happy Thanksgiving, Monsignor.
I put my sauerkraut together last night. Had a little bit for breakfast. It's pretty good.
Nice. Awesome.
Good beginning. In the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
We come together in prayer to give praise to God. We also acknowledge our sinfulness and we ask God to forgive us. You were sent to heal the contrite.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You plead for us at the right hand of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Father, all powerful, your gifts of love are countless and your goodness infinite. As we come before you on Thanksgiving Day with gratitude for your kindness, open our hearts to have concern for every man, woman, and child, so that we may share your gifts in loving service. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Sirach. And now, God, who has done wondrous things on earth, who fosters people's growth from their mother's womb and fashions them according to his will, may he grant you joy of heart and may peace abide among you. May his goodness toward us endure in Israel to deliver us in our days. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. I give thanks to my God always on your account for the grace of God bestowed on you in Christ Jesus, that in him you were enriched in every way with all discourse and all knowledge, as the testimony to Christ was confirmed among you, so that you are not
other nine with leprosy. They're cured. In their moment of need, they have faith. The Samaritan, however, really catches on to something that Jesus is trying to express. The Samaritan didn't know where to go. Because he was a Samaritan, and he was told to present himself to the priest, which was the ordinary thing to do if you were relieved of this dreaded disease, leprosy. He didn't know where to go. He didn't know whether he should go back to Mount Gerizim, to his own priest. The Samaritans were an offshoot of Judaism, but considered an illegitimate offshoot of Judaism. So he didn't know if he was supposed to go back to them, or if he was supposed to find a Jewish priest to go to. If he found a Jewish priest to go to, the Jewish priest was unlikely to acknowledge this miracle on his behalf, simply because he was a Samaritan. And yet, it was a Jewish rabbi who healed him. And presenting that scenario to a Samaritan priest wasn't going to go over well either. And so what did he do? He went back to the source. He went back to Jesus Christ and gave praise and thanksgiving for being delivered from this horrendous disease. He was in a difficult moment. He didn't know where to go. And that's precisely the point that Jesus is making. His decision to return to Jesus in that moment was exactly what Jesus wanted to portray to everyone. There is a new way. There is a new understanding of the source of the power of God, and it rests in Jesus Christ. Now, the other nine, they were told, and they went off to the priest, but really it was the Samaritan who saw the breakthrough here. The Samaritan saw this breakthrough and said, I can't go to either. And so there must be something else that I can do. And he recognizes in this moment the message of
Lord, hear our prayer.
For local and national leaders, may God grant them compassion and wisdom in their decision making. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are sick or suffering, may the Lord place his healing hand upon them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our faith community who on this Thanksgiving, may the Lord show us the many things for which we are to be grateful. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who die this day, may the Lord shine his face upon them and bring them to his eternal rest. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Lord, hear our prayer.
Almighty God, on this day we give you thanks. We particularly give you thanks for the presence of your Son in our lives. Help us to recognize that presence in all we do and all we face. We make our prayer in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Find out
your spirit.
Let us offer you the sign of Christ's peace.
The prayer of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
this celebration, O Lord, our God. You have shown us the depths of your love for all your children. Help us, we pray, to reach out in love to all your people, so that we may share with them the good things of time and eternity. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
Happy Thanksgiving.
You too, Father.